What is going on, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. Welcome back to Opera Anna. My name is Anna. I am an opera singer, and I am here to opera up your life. Let's get into the April news. One of the most important, or at least most publicized, events of the year took place on April 24th this past week. The Laffont Competitions, previously known as the Metropolitan Opera National Council Auditions. They had their semi-finals in which they chose 10 singers to advance to the finals. These singers will be able to perform with orchestra on the Met stage, and the semifinals they performed with piano. These 10 singers included American mezzo-soprano Anne Marie Stanley, American soprano Esther Tonea, Chinese bass baritone Le Bu, Canadian tenor Matthew Cairns, and Swiss bass Jonas Judd, among other Americans and Americans. And some more Americans, yeah. The finals of this competition will take place on May 1st at 3 p.m. Eastern Time, so New York time, and the grand finals concert will be hosted by Nadine Sierra. We'll see what comes out of that. There's definitely some really good singers in this group, for sure. We'll see what happens. We'll see what happens. Breaking news, everybody. The finals of the Laffont competition took place this past Sunday on May 1st, and I could not wait until the May news, which would be in a month from now, to give you the results. So here I am with some breaking news for this April edition. 6 of the 10 singers were chosen as winners after their performance on May 1st at the Metropolitan Opera, and their names are bass baritone Le Bu, tenor Matthew Cairns, sopranos Alexandra Razkazov, Julie Rosette, and Esther Tonea, and mezzo-soprano Anne Marie Stanley. All 6 winners will receive $20,000 in cash.
What?
As their prize, as well as career assistance, is how the Met formulates that. The 4 singers who didn't win will still receive $10,000 cash.
What?
And be able to call themselves finalists in the Met competition. I mean, like, that's amazing. That's amazing. And so amazing to everyone who won, who were finalists, who were semifinalists, who put themselves out there just to audition in the first place, even if they didn't get admitted to the competition, even though they thought their audition tapes were actually really good, but they didn't get chosen. Like, what is that about, Met competition? What the heck? Asking for a friend. Unfortunately, they only audio streamed the finals of this competition for some reason. Who knows? The semifinals were live recorded, but okay. The recording is also nowhere to be found unless you are smarter than me and you have been able to find it, but I unfortunately have not. So if you didn't see it, you are shit out of luck. I hope the recording will be available soon somewhere, either on the Met on Demand that you have to have a subscription for, or YouTube somewhere. I mean, it would be amazing just to hear these singers again and see how they did in the finals if you weren't able to make it the first time. And now back to the official news. Thank you. So at the beginning of April, I discovered the world's youngest professional opera singer, so dubbed by the Guinness Book of World Records. She is 10-year-old Victory Brinker, who performed with the Pittsburgh Public Theater's Lights and Legends show when she was only 7 years old and 314 days. The elementary school student is now just getting started, according to becauseofthemwecan.com, working overtime to maintain her voice and technique. And overtime and to maintain are so ironic, it's not even funny. She posted this very, very cute picture on Instagram with her certificate. Amazing. I set a Guinness World Record while performing on Italian TV. I was surprised with the Guinness World Record title of world's youngest opera singer based on my very first opera contract at age 7 years and 314 days. We can hear her singing one of the most difficult arias, Mozart's Der Höhle Rache from Die Zauberflöte. I'm just gonna give it a quick listen. She is very cute. Very, like, there's a lot of control in the voice. It's clear that she's talented. There's no doubt about that. We do hear the incredibly fast vibrato that comes with not having a stable breath support. She's breathing everywhere. She is a little kid, so that is to be expected. That's not even my issue with it. This is not new. There have been countless of young opera singers who go on America's Next, I wouldn't say Next Top Model, no, who go on America's Got Talent, wow the judges and the public alike with their renditions of totally inappropriate arias, Nessun Dorma, Der Hülle Rache, just everything under the sun. Very, very difficult pieces to sing, and I give them extreme kudos for being able to control their voice in that way at such a young age. The thing about these is that their voices are too young to be singing this repertoire, and they will earlier damage their voices by trying to do all the different technical skills that are needed before their voice is ready for it. So yes, she is very talented. Is she on her way to become the next star of opera? No, I don't know. We had Jackie Evancho, who sang O Mio Babbino Caro in America's Got Talent. Aman Bisha, who sang Nessun Dorma. Why is it that the general public only responds like this to performances of opera when it's performed, albeit impressively, but at a mediocre level at best by a non-opera singer? It's not just children. We saw it also with Jennifer Hudson, who sang Nessun Dorma in the wrong key with an orchestra belting out a high F. Also very impressive, but it wasn't good. And we see this where people just lose their minds because they're young and they hear this voice. And then I could almost guarantee you that if I went and did the same thing, or any one of my colleagues went and did the same thing, that we would not be received with the same enthusiasm. It's just incredibly frustrating. So we're gonna move on. The ever-recurring theme of Anna Netrebko and her drama in the world. So, after her last statement distancing herself from Russia and from the war in Ukraine, having originally denounced the war in Ukraine, the violence in Ukraine, as she put it, the Siberia-based Novosibirsk Opera announced a cancellation of a concert in which she was set to perform. Quote, living in Europe and having the opportunity to perform in European concert halls appears to be more important than the fate of the homeland. Our country is brimming with talent, and the idols of yesterday will be replaced by others with a clear civic position. That is harsh. I can't even imagine how she would begin to feel, although if you're distancing, you're like, that you have to expect something like this. But wait, there's more. On April 21st, Slipdisk reported that a leading Putin newspaper in Russia reported that Anna Netrebko is expected back in Russia to perform at Valery Gergiev's White Nights Festival that runs from May to July. Not saying that Valery Gergiev has literally nothing other to do. It's not a surprise to see that he's in Russia. Was that harsh? I feel like that was harsh. This exact same newspaper recently accused her of treason. So, like, what? Her crime is now forgiven? And what? I'm confused. I'm very confused. But sure. Next up, something a little uplifting having to do with the war in Ukraine. April 20th, it was announced that the musicians of the Metropolitan Opera donated $17,000 directly to the musicians of the National Opera House of Ukraine. That's craziness. donations from the Met Orchestra, the Metropolitan Opera's music staff, and a significant donation from music director Yannick Nezid-Seguin were raised with the hope that it demonstrates our solidarity with all musicians in Ukraine who are in this impossible crisis. Amazing. Amazing. I love it. I love it. Lastly, backing up a bit in time, although I know people are still suffering from this disease, from this illness, COVID. Renee Fleming, obviously a star soprano and has been busy in the world of music therapy for a while now, has found a new purpose for her, quote, world-class breath control, helping people suffering from long COVID. Last year, she started a new online initiative called Healing Breath. Rightfully so, they are experts in breathing. Singers work every day on expanding the breath, getting it deeper, getting it longer, all these different things. It kind of makes sense. She says the idea is to enable long COVID patients or any person with lung problems to extend their breath to help them breathe more, to help them breathe better, excuse me. Interestingly enough, Fleming actually would like to see the arts being fully integrated into the healthcare system as a way to heal, as a way to prevent, and is praising efforts to do so in Britain and some US states. She will also return to the Paris Opera next year, 2023, for the Nixon in China premiere by John Adams. Now, I am a massive, massive fan of John Adams, so I just might be making the trek down to Paris to see her perform. Never seen her in opera. Have seen her in concert, but not in opera. And that was the whirlwind news of opera in the past month of April. Thank you so much for joining me. I hope you enjoyed the video. Let me know your comments below of what's going on in the world of opera this month. I hope you enjoyed. I hope you could opera up your life a little bit. Don't forget to subscribe and like the video, and I will see you next time. Addio. Addio, addio, speranza in anima.